Lord, can bring us to our feet and right now, our pastor for today's message.
Amen.
Praise the Lord.
Thank you, Jesus.
Praise the name of Jesus.
Amen.
Something good is going to happen. Something beautiful is in store. Oh, we are together again. Praising the Lord, praising God. We are together again. Praising the Lord. Oh, we are together again. Thank you, Lord. In Jesus' name we are praying.
Amen.
Amen. Be seated. This message that I'm preaching this morning, six steps to walking out the power. It originated from the movie I've been watching. It's been season, you know. I was sharing with my wife yesterday. I said, this movie is not good. That's why I'm not going to mention the name of the movie. But I'm going to teach you the lessons. I'm going to share something. So that even if you encounter the movie tomorrow, you will know, you will guide yourself with the teaching of today. Now, why is it important, Pastor Joseph, that you are watching the movie but you don't want another person? It's not that I don't want another person. Just, I believe when you're mature enough, you'll be able, when you're watching something, you'll be able to filter the good. Now we are in a world where Hollywood is preaching more messages than the church. We are in a world where the youth, Australia, their mentor is America. And in America now, there is no control for explicit. Even people don't have control for their libido any longer. They don't have control. So the whole thing going on the street, movies cannot sell unless they get the news. That's what sells movie now. And the guy, the one of the characters in the movie I'm talking about, which is to tell you that he's on the high class, is 50 Cent. How many of you know 50 Cent? And you know how. So, but the movie is not, if you're not mature, the movie will start spoiling. Like I've been watching the movie, I've been nothing, it has not changed anything. It has not in any way. Rather, because when I watch movie, I don't just watch what is happening. I try to understand the understanding of the writer. But I'm curious, but I'm a kind of, because of, it's something that is on the street. Anybody can assess it. Now, why am I interested in the movie? It's just exactly what happens to us as Christian. Exactly, but this is on the physical side, and the way they are handling it on the movie, instead of showing us the biblical way to handle those challenges, they are now showing us only the human way to handle it. Does that make sense? Do you understand what I'm saying? There are challenges of life, we cannot run away from it. Is that true? We can't run away from challenges of life, no matter what. But how the movie is teaching us to handle it is why I'm preaching this message. So that I teach you too how to handle it spiritually. Does that make sense? Now, what is the movie talking about? Remember my topic this morning? 6 steps to work out the power that is in you. It's not to work out your salvation. To work out the power that is in you. There's a power in you. There's a power in you that you don't need any other thing except that power to bring to pass. Now, let me give you a little background of that movie, what it looks like. And then I will share with you, give you an example, teach you on how to solve such a problem. Amen? Now, the movie is about somebody that want to go legit. That's an American way of saying legal. Does that make sense? You just want to be a good man. You want to be a good father. You want to be a good businessman. You just want to be good in everything. Does that make sense? And his background, he was brought up in a ghetto. You know what you call ghetto? When you're brought up in a ghetto in America, it's hard for you to be responsible because it's a spoiled area. The major business there is drug, stealing, jacking cars, you know. It's the worst place. And to the extent that America has left that area for the blacks. So whenever you grow from that place, it's hard. You know another thing, all these black musicians that are very wealthy, most of them came out from ghetto. Very rich, but you see how they died. This guy, almost all of them, 50 Cent, they were all stealing before they went to jail so many times. A lot of them, the one building Sierra Leone, doing everything in Africa, he said. But now, when they are, because of how wealthy they are, the same police that were putting them in prison, when they see them on the street, they start taking pictures with them. Hey, hey, hey. So, they came out from that ghetto, but the protagonist of this movie vowed never that his children will not pass through what he passed through. So he moved from ghetto to the city. But he has already been involved in all this street life, big time, to the extent he's like a champion. Does that make sense? And thinking he can get legit or legal by his human wisdom. That's the movie. Season 1, season 2, season 3, season 4, season 5. Up to season 5. Anytime you want to get legit in business, another problem will come. Sometimes it will be a problem he has had before. Sometimes it is his own weaknesses. He can't control his libido. Does that make sense? Sometimes the wife now got angry because of the way he was treated, because he made an agreement with the wife and they have been working towards it. His wife now got angry and starts, you know, she gets, you know, start behaving, committing adultery. When the man finds out, and the man has made his agreement with his wife that there's no option for divorce, but yet, when he needs encouragement because of what he do, what he does, what he's doing, he will now look for encouragement either through drinking or through another woman. Are you getting it now? This is somebody that has taken a decision the way you have taken a concrete decision to serve God, to live right. He took a decision. But every step he made to run away from the illegal things he was doing, the more he entered into illegal things. Then I said, some of the youths might be watching this and they will think it's a way out. But I'm here to tell you that you can decide, no matter the background you came out from, no matter the gate you came out from, after this teaching, you find out that it's possible for you to get labor, legit. Does that make sense? I'm a living example. I've seen Christians in Australia. They don't allow their children to watch television. I'm telling you the truth. I've stayed with them when I came newly into, and they don't allow their children to watch. They filter what their children watch. I learned a lot of things from them, but I didn't learn that one. Do you know why I didn't learn that one? It's not necessary. Archbishop versus us, I say, let them do it in our presence. If there is one that is wrong, we'll correct them. Because the television, they can't run away from it. They can't run away. So me and my wife, we have stem, we have foster, we have Netflix, and we now have DTV, digital television. But we always there watching. My mom, if I'm not there, my wife is there watching what they are watching. They have their iPads. We can't stop them from there. And they are connected to the internet. But I have, in my little wisdom of having technology, I coded it that they cannot get an application without me. I have to sign it before they get any application. So they cannot just, they cannot. And you know, I keep on trying my daughter, testing her. When she was younger, just like 3 years, I tested her with money. Gave her $5, go to school, bring back my $3. Usually, she went and finished it. She came and said, where's my $3? He said, that was glory. I waited when she was 4 years old. I did the same thing. I said, go to school. She's not into primary school. I tested her. I said, go to school, bring this one. And she still remembers what she did when she was 3 years. And she went and brought back my change. I shook her hand. At the time, this application, I gave her the password. I trusted her. I was just testing her. And she went and downloaded the application instantly. And when I found out, up to today, she's still begging me to forgive her. I locked it up, deleted Instagram, and to change my password. I know when to test her again. Why am I saying? It's not them watching the television that is, it's what you are building in them. The power that is at work. Are you getting the point? And every stage of your life, and I know I might not test favor, I might not test, but I found out that favor and the twins, their mentor is glory. Does that make sense? So if I can walk on glory, and glory do the is doing the right thing, it will also affect the younger ones. I've been with family, they don't allow their children, but my whole family, I get all these things for them. But because I have enough time to be with them, my wife is there. My wife was a teacher. So everything, very much my wife doesn't understand. And they cannot go to their room to browse. They will stay in the park. Where when mommy is going around, she's seeing what they are doing. And you get what I'm saying? Why? Because if we don't teach them in our house, the street has the same thing to offer. And do you think I'm making sense? But when you start teaching them from home, so that's the main reason why that movie, you will see how it's going to end. It will either end, because it has not ended, is a serial, seasonal movie. You will see it will end that the son will become a better criminal than the father. Because I'm seeing the step. Sometimes when I think, watch movies, the man who cannot change. But he has started going to church now to ask for way out. And the first thing the man told him, the pastor told him, so he asked him a question and said, who are you blaming for everything that is happening? He said, my son, my wife, my girlfriend, my niece, my dad, everybody was just blaming everybody around me. And I've taught you something here. Who can remember? About character.
Taking responsibility.
That's right. So you see, that's the first step. And the pastor asks him, in all these people you are blaming, what is your own position? You say, my position, what is it? He said, okay, I lie a lot. He said, go and start with changing all the lies. He didn't tell him because America, you have to be, it's not like me that is wrong. I'm not civilized, I'm wrong. I'll tell you, your problem is you. And the man started, you know. But yet, there are lies he has not accepted to confess to his children. And that brought me to this. I was like that. But my own is different because I held on to the truth. You shall know the truth. And the truth will make you free. Does that make sense? His own is trying to use his human wisdom. Somebody will say his will. Your will is nothing. You know, two types of people on earth. People that are holding on to the will of God and people that are holding on to their own will. Two types of people on earth. People that on the last day, God will say, you, let it be done according to your will. And people that will come and God say, because you did it according to my will, come into my church. Am I making sense? I'm trying, this message is for everybody, but especially for Jimmy. Because of your next level, let me share something with you to make you understand. I fought my way through. I grew in Christianity among fake pastors, among pastors that are liars. That is why every time you see me, they go, I cannot talk about criminal pastors. I grew. I didn't know anything. Innocently, I served God at that time. I served God under a man of integrity, Bishop Basile Ebuhasa. And when I came overseas, I never knew. Instead of Church of God Mission handing over genuine ministers to look after, the only genuine minister that looked after us was Reverend Dr. Odi and his team. Reverend Dr. Odi. But when they asked me to submit to America and submit to Japan, they were all criminals. I'm on the net. I'm the only pastor that talk the way I talk. Because what I see is the last day, the judgment day. I don't see now. I see when God will say, did you expose those things that you are against?
American bishop there one day called me in my house and said, "Idika, you are in Malaysia. Stop preaching righteousness and holiness. Make the people comfortable so that they'll be coming to your church. Otherwise, you have no member." The bishop in America. And when he finished advising, he said, "Kneel down, let me pray for you." I said, "God forbid, over Jesus. You've just told me never to preach righteousness and holiness so that the church will grow. Your church has not even grown. At least at that time, we have over 150 members." I said, "Instead of me to preach Guinness." And he was working with Japan. So how can I grow in the midst of this kind of? And you expect me to trust any pastor? You expect me to trust the system? You expect me to believe the system? While everybody representing them are criminals? That was my experience. I'm coming somewhere. I'm trying to tell you something. Jimmy, don't forget the story I'm telling you. Because it might happen to you. Moses has not survived it. Moses, the pastor we handed over to Malaysia, has not survived this thing that I'm telling you now. He didn't survive it. Because they used him. When they couldn't get him, they wanted to use Moses. And they spoiled Moses, destroyed everything I taught Moses. Now, when they were fighting, when they tried me, when they come, America and Japan, that time, bam, and they find out that I'm stubborn. Imagine them telling all my members, "Send all your phone numbers. We want your phone numbers, your email address. We want to give you an ID card." I say, "Where has it ever happened? Everything, every meeting you have with is, Mama, you know, Mama want to make fair with presiding bishop, but the next person that's supposed to be presiding bishop is exempt. All you are doing in international front is politics. Anywhere, Kenny will be the spokesman. And Japan will be the one that will say, is Ezekiel that is supposed to be the next presiding bishop? It's not fair." So what were they doing? They were trying to use the international front to intimidate Mama to hand over to Ezekiel as the presiding bishop. And this meeting were 2008, 2009 in Malaysia. This was the kind of environment I found myself. This was the kind of setting. I have been brought up to preach the gospel. I'm not talking about the gospel, the truth. And now I came to international front. I met politicians parading as pastors, criminals. I'm coming. Do you know when I was in the midst of this trouble and fight? I wanted to be the best. I wanted not to compromise. But that was when I married my wife. Jimmy, listen to me. That was when I married my wife. And my wife, in her innocence, she came to Malaysia. You know, remember, I didn't cut with my wife. Nothing. I didn't know her from Adam. I just met her. I was going back to Malaysia and saw her. I came back and wedded her. I went back to Malaysia. No relation, nothing at all. So my wife has not really known me. At the same time, people are talking because of my style. They see this, I call it black. I don't harbor anything in my heart. I just say the things the way I want it. So people have been talking to her. So in the midst of this, my wife now saw me fighting. "I cannot preach. I cannot. Everybody, America, fighting. Japan, fighting. Everywhere. When I call headquarters and say, what is happening? Are we all criminals?" Headquarters will say, "You are the criminal." They will, you know, bah. And when my wife, remember, this guy is struggling. The guy I'm using from the movie. To be legit. To be legal. The same way I was struggling. Not to contaminate myself. My wife entered into my life, came to Malaysia. "My wife said, who did I marry?" She wasn't seeing Azana. She wasn't seeing Kenny. She wasn't seeing my battle with headquarters to tell them there is something evil happening at the She was only seeing me every time. And a man, you know, I'm a warrior, I'm a fighter. Every time, fighting, fighting. And my wife is the type that doesn't like. So when she came into my life, if there was any time I would have divorced my wife or separated from my wife, it's that time. Instead of my wife coming like human expectation, and I didn't know at that time because I was still a baby, I said, what is it? Do you know what I'm fighting? Do you know the problem? My wife doesn't know whether I came from a good background, whether she doesn't know anything, and moreover, she's an Anglican. She doesn't know anything. Now I'm fighting, I'm trying to resist the devil. So do you know what was happening in my marriage? My wife became scared of me. Scared as I'm dangerous. I can kill. I learn. Now, Jimmy, why am I telling all this? I survived it. You will survive it. You learn from my mistakes. Yeah. Remember, this struggle, I want to do the right thing. But my wife doesn't understand. This is a woman I love so much. This is this and that. Became. I said, no. But in my little understanding, not knowing that I'm the one to teach her, to make her understand my vision and what is happening. And it's not bad. And I was doing it bad. I know as a young man, my blood was very hot at that time. He needed to wah, wah. Oh, I said, one day you come back here and I'll go home. I'll carry my bag and go. This is your trouble and wahala. I don't like it. You are a trouble man. I'll go inside the room and cry. My wife will see it. Sometimes I will do 3 days to dry fast. I said, Lord, if I make a mistake in my marriage, I've lost everything. My wife will see it. My wife will still come back and say, if really you are this, but why is it that you went for dry fasting? Why is it that you went for dry? If really, what? I'm confused. Why is it that I'll tell you that I don't like this marriage and want to go, but instead of you attacking me, you go into dry fasting, crying and praying, and the way you pray, as if something. My wife says, okay, let me watch. Now, listen very, very well. It was only a word of God, God revealed to me, that solved that problem. All you need is just you want to say something, tell you something. A good name is better than silver. That's all. That's the reward. I say, what does that mean, God? I'm talking about my marriage. My wife doesn't understand me. My wife feels I'm a troublemaker. But if I compromise, I have no future in ministry. What is happening? How will I make my wife understand? Please! And you know another thing? I'm good with Facebook. In the morning, instead of keeping quiet, I'll go on Facebook. And the people that are dealing with me will be rejoicing. Because they are knowing what I'm doing. They are predicting me. He's angry. And my wife will be telling me, stop writing this. Stop sending this on Facebook. They are seeing you and they will keep on doing what they are doing. I thought it's to fight back. Are you getting my message? And I was doing this until I got revelation of that word. Good name is better than silver. I started praying about it. I said, God, I don't understand. What has this word got to do? He said, now when I got the revelation, he said, your wife was being looked after, trained by her parents for how many years? Over 20 years. And when you married her, she changed her name to yours. What else? And you know, there is no love greater than this, that for a man to die for his wife. So I now said, oh, so this is a great thing. I said, okay, you trusted me, left Nigeria, followed me to Australia. I mean Malaysia. And all I've been doing is carrying you because I wanted to see. Mama the Boyan also helped. Reverend Dr. Esther the Boyan, he helped me. You see, whatever people are saying, you don't blame them. It's how they understand it. Why not just keep quiet and walk towards where God is taking you to? And one day. So I started seeing anytime I'm having problems, I say, I would kind of talk to my wife. I say, please, love, I'm not a troublemaker. But it's all these challenges, and I want to be legit. I want to be legal. I want to do something the right way. This is my opportunity to right my wrongs. And I said, whatever I'm doing to you, I started talking to my wife. I said, I trust you because you trusted me. You left everything in Nigeria and you followed me to Malaysia. You also followed me to Australia. But you see, other men will be thinking they are doing good for their wife. But I decided to be the other way around. And I'm still doing it up today. I'll call my wife. Is that war? A good name is better than several. I started walking towards that. My wife, thank you for trusting me. Thank you for trusting me. It wasn't up to 3 years. After all this, because I was struggling, fighting the battles within and without. And the person watching me that is not seeing other people became scared of me. That our marriage was only very hot because you can't blame her. She doesn't know me from Adam. Now see me every time fighting Facebook, fighting Japan, fighting America. No. Oh, you are a trouble man. And when we had leaders visited us to Malaysia, all the leaders, somebody went and lied to them. And when the person lied to them, and the leaders called me, in my word of not being civilized, I busted out in anger. But what say? Hey, I better need to one chance. This man is Terminator. Brazilian and Jet Li joined together. Oh. He's always fighting. Oh. I'm not a fighting type. She said, one day you come home, you see me carry my bag, you go across River Niger and go back to Nigeria. I said, please. I started working on it. Now I started, miracle started after 3 years. She called me and said, I've been watching you. I've been watching, especially what you say and the testimonies you give. I see you when you are at all, when there is, when you overwhelm, you go to the rock higher than you. You pray. You pray intensive prayer. I see it's not just prayer. It means that you really determine. My wife said, I've been watching you for 3 years. And there are things you say. I've been trying, but I found out that those things are true. Because when you are saying it, it's just this, you don't miss a word, you don't add it on. And I was, this one now, okay, when we now came to Australia, my wife said, your sisters have also confirmed. When they tell me the story of how you began with God, when you were there, it's just the same thing you said. Now, 2011, remember, I have started my wife. I have made her friend. She thought I'm a very wise person, you know? I want to finish before 11:30, and I'll try. In 2011, I came to Malaysia, Bishop Fredano, my personal papa. He was with me at the step when we were going up to the lift. He said, look at you. Other people carry the anointing of Archbishop versus the answer, prosperity. But you went and carried his fighting spirit. I said, Daddy, what did he say? He said, well, did I say anything? He said, he said anything. I went to Nigeria. I'm telling you, the least person there was me and other reverend ministers. It was coordinators, presbyters, bishops, and the school of bishops, and archbishop. And everybody was talking. In fact, as they were accusing me, imagine bringing more than 100 something. This is the battle. I thought I was going to win. Remember, I started fighting this battle in 2008. And the same two people came, Azenebo and Kenny. The allegation The against me was more than 100. And before then, I've already had the revelation. That was November 2011. I've already had the revelation by April of what was going to happen, dream. And in that dream, I didn't say anything. So when I went there, Mama was presenting it through it. Everybody was doing it. But you are this, you are a fraudster, you are a criminal, you are that, everybody. Remember, from 2011, I'm fighting this battle with them in there.
And when they now talk, to you, listen to me, there was so much talk that I believed that I was mad. I'm telling you the truth. These are people you are looking on to. These are the leaders, most powerful people on earth. From the way you have seen them, there's no guineas in Church of One Mission. The foundation of Church of One Mission, led by Archbishop is very solid. And the same people. Do you know what saved me that day? I came out thinking, and that would have been the end of my ministry. Because I now believe that I was a madman. Imagine my wife has confirmed it. Every time fighting, every day. So when I came out, the next call I got was my father-in-law, my wife's father. And he called me. When he called me, in my openness, and honestly, I said, yeah, you asked me, how was the meeting? I said, my old in-law, in fact, I have today found out I'm a mad person. That was what I told my father-in-law. I said, I'm a mad person. Because imagine, even my own spiritual father, Bishop Edo, I said, in that meeting, he called me a gold digger. Many of that they called me a fraudster, they called me a criminal. The only thing I didn't do was I told our bishop, in our culture as Igbo man, you don't tell your father that he's wrong because it was through our bishop, those things were coming, and through Onenea, if you say that even Moses told him that if you don't remove this man, he's a terror. And you know this is only one thing, this man is a terror. And yet, so I told my father-in-law, I think the problem is me. She's taking responsibility. I'm a madman. My father-in-law laughed. He said, let me tell you, my son, there are people that God has created like that. Unless they fight, they will never succeed. Watch out. That's what my father-in-law told me. He said, yeah, you're that type of person. There are people that God created. My father-in-law is my best friend. Where has he not represented me spiritually and physically? Before my wife traveled on the trip that she saw me, her father had a dream and called her and said, I had a dream. If there's any man that talks to you, bring the man home. I know you don't like it. There are people you see, their noses like this. You know? Bring anybody that talks to you home. Let me leave myself because I had a dream. Now, when I felt I was mad, my father-in-law was the one that told me, Idika, you are not mad. It's how God created you. You can, you, what if you don't fight, you don't eat. You are created like that. You are a warrior. I said, wow. Now, do you know the final one? I came home to my wife. I said, sweetheart, I now found out my problem. My problem is that I'm mad. I'm always fighting. He said, what? I said, I'm going to walk on fighting. I'm not going to fight again. He said, you can't stop fighting. This woman. He said, you can't stop fighting. We are where we are today because of your fight. Before I used to think you are fighting against me. Now I know you are fighting our enemies. You must fight. I said, no, easy. He said, you are a fighter. You must fight. No one can talk about my mind. When you fight, I have something to tell them. I said, are you all right? Did you get my message? The other guy said, the other guy in the movie had the same problem. But because he doesn't have these 6 keys, but I have it. And look at it, everything has turned around. Even my leaders up to today, even those people, Azenebo and Kenny, they are scared of me. They call me naked wire. Be careful when you come near to him. He
He's always, his electricity is shocking, is too much. And until they found out that I'm a warrior, I'm a fighter, they never, you see how I talk? I'm on media, it's just going everywhere in the world. In fact, people are listening to it. But why am I saying all these things? It's to tell you that it doesn't matter the decision you have made that is good in the Bible. If you make that decision, everything around you will want to pull you down, even your own weakness. But the only way out is Ephesians chapter 3, verse 20. Ephesians chapter 3, verse 20. What is it?
Now to him who is able to do.
He's able to do.
Immeasurably.
Immeasurably.
More than all we ask.
More than all we ask.
Or imagine.
Or imagine.
According to his power that is above.
It doesn't matter what you have decided to do that is good. James 3:13. If thou be a doer of that which is good, nobody can harm you. Nothing can stop you. Archbishop mentioned in the house, I said, the greatest message I have for my generation, for my children, is that none of you that want to change the story of your family, that God will not support. God will help you to change. Look at me, I'm a testimony. Look at the trip we made to Nigeria. One of my boys that was with me, if you see the text message, he said, Pastor, oh, you know, we have a new way. No, say, Pastor, it ain't called that pastor. Say, Abambo. When you use this word, it's like somebody that is serving somebody. But you serve to the extent you become greater than your master. That's when you say, Abambo. That's the kind of the word, that's the weight of the word. He said, Pastor, with what I have seen with this your trip in Nigeria, Pastor Abrahambo. Abrahambo more than the pastor does. Where who a pastor Abrahambo can? Your achievement. Is it not the pastor I serve the Malaysian? Now it's the pastor I'm seeing in Nigeria. Even we that think we are rich. Pastor Abrahambo. This was the man that his destiny would have been destroyed because of my weaknesses. This is not somebody, my own weakness of being wrong, not knowing when to talk and not when to know when to get angry, not controlling my anger. Yet the Bible says, but in that my situation, I would have determined to be the best husband. Did I mean to be the best father? Did I mean to be the greatest pastor ever known? Yes, things around me wanted. When I saw my wife, I said, no. God gave me revelation. I said, good name is better than that. I said, this woman has given all. She has given me more than money. She has given me only submitting to answer my name. From princess on out. To now, Princess Diga. Church, you get one thing. What to him that he's able to do? Exceedingly, according, above even the way you think, but according to the power you are able to raise within you. Now, the responsibility now, your responsibility is to raise the power. What are those powers? Quickly give me Ecclesiastes. Go to Ecclesiastes, let me rush down the six steps. If you must escape from anything that want to pull you down, with your weakness, your marriage, the friends around you, the community, the foundation you were brought up from, everything, the system. Chapter 9, verse 7, start from 7. Number 1, you must be accepted by God. Verse 1. Verse 7. Read fast, I don't have time.
Go, eat your food with gladness.
Go, eat your food with gladness.
And drink your wine with
gladness. Drink your wine. Yes,
why? It is now that God favors you.
Can you have pigeons? Jimmy, please, if you don't have pigeons, have pigeons back. Is there no pigeons? What's the version? Anyone, what's the version of that? Okay, Rich. You can borrow my watch. Maybe I can get it. Always, please, if you don't have to just right, I'll give you. Yes. Read. Put your phone on the floor.
Who is he that will harm you? What, sorry?
Ecclesiastes chapter 9 said, I don't have time, I want to finish the next 2 minutes, 3 minutes, or 5 minutes.
Go that way.
Go that way. Number one, God must accept you. Make sure God has accepted your call. God has accepted what you are doing. God has accepted you as his son. Read.
Eat that bread with joy.
Mm-hmm.
And drink that wine with a merry heart.
Mm-hmm.
For God now accepted thy works.
Which means you are now in the will of God for your life. You have discovered your will. Does that make sense? Number two, let your garments always be white. Mm-hmm. Continue.
Let thy garments be always white.
Live a righteous life. Live. Please, don't allow. God has accepted you. He has made you clean. By accepting you means you are clean. But don't allow that your white clothes, they clean. Don't allow anything to spot it. If you see anything, any mistake, correct it. If you change the word of God and the life you're living is not in alignment, change it. Change it immediately. I'm giving you the 6 steps. If you want to walk out, the power that is already in you. When you accepted Jesus as your Lord and Savior, the power is residing in you. It is residing in you. Church, are you getting what I'm saying? So how now God has accepted you? Start working out that power. That is how. That's the only way. Anything you want to achieve. That's what. That's how I am where I am today. Today I'm teaching others. Today I'm training pastors. Today I have many pastors under me. Because I was able to pass through and was not destroyed. Let not your garment lack, let your garment always be white. And let what? The next one.
Let thy head lack no ointment.
Let thy head lack no ointment. It means never break away. Go and ask questions. No, my leaders might not like me, but I have not broken away. I have not broken ranks. The same oil is still flowing from Archbishop to the house. It's still flowing. Let not your oil. It's lit. The Bible says how good and pleasant it is for brothers to be in unity. Psalms 133. Verse 1. He says it's like the oil upon the head of Aaron to his bed, from his bed to his head. Let not the oil flowing, don't break it. No breakaway, no giving. If God is telling you to leave the church you are, make sure there is an agreement with the people you have served, the people pouring all year. Do not allow that all year. Are you getting what I'm saying? Don't, because of problem, don't divorce unto him that is able to do exceeding above it, which means even what you are thinking is small, he can still do more. The time you're passing through those shaking is the time of training and testing. Number one, make sure God has accepted what you're doing. It's pure. Number two, anytime you see stain in your body, clean it. Number three, the oil is flowing because the assignment is not side by side. It's not man's business, it's God's business. Make sure it's from the top. Even when Jesus came, you still recognize Moses. But he said that the one greater than Moses is here. But you see, Moses did. He came, there was glory upon his head. He testified of the good things happening to Moses. That he, to this end, that Moses had to cover his face. But he said that it's not like his own. His own, the thing has been turned into two. You can even see the brightness, enjoy the brightness, and live with the brightness. Does that make sense?
Yep.
Now, what's the fourth one?
Live joyfully.
Marriage.
With the wife whom thou lovest all the days of thy life, of thy vanity,
mm-hmm.
which he has given thee under the sun, all the days of thy vanity. For that is thy portion.
For that is thy portion. Now listen. If God tells you that your wife or your husband is the only portion, only blessing I'm giving you. How will you treat him or her? Let's say it. If God said, this is your wife I'm giving you, and God said, you have been asking me to bless you, you have been asking me to change your life, you have been asking me to improve your life, you want to be the richest, the greatest in Lucia, the only blessing I'm going to give you to bring it to comfort is this your wife. Will you ever think of divorcing her? If that's it, the Bible says the only portion will be there.
Live joyfully with
the last statement.
For that is thy portion in this life. And in thy labor,
that is that T-H-Y, right? Yeah. Which is only you. Only for you alone. Church, if God tells you that this is the way you're going to prosper, this is the key. It is true. My wife is multiplying everything the way she multiplied. One spermatozoa. I have now, I mean, four spermatozoa. I have four children. That's the way she's multiplying my anointing. She's multiplying my revelation. She's multiplying everything. But people doesn't have not called this. I called it. That is why her name is my portion. My name, if your mama, is my portion. My beautiful portion. That's her name. That's what I call her since I married her. And she also feels, imagine a priestess seeing a poor, poor, wretched boy like me. And he's also saying, I'm your mama. Who does she want to give her? Priestess. Red-headed, stubborn boy. You know, from poor family. Not even, she's saying, I'm also, you are my, also my question. That's why when she coming like that, you know. I say, priestess. You know? So take it on. So number four, don't divorce your wife. Don't dissolve your husband. There's something, the reason why God has brought you together. It doesn't matter, it might take 10 years or 20 years before, but when it comes out, you become the greatest. Junior, you hear what I'm saying? I passed through it, but the challenge I have, none of the people are here. They were interested in my success. They were interested in my money. They were interested in me bringing them to preach in Malaysia and Australia. They were interested. None of them wanted to hear me. None of them had a listening ear, except I keep on mentioning Reverend Dr. Udi and ABA, Bishop ABA. They were the only people that had listening ear. And when they listened to me and heard me, they took a decision. Though that decision was challenged, but yet they made a step. They took a step. Dr. Udi said, we can never, all the people you are owing in Nigeria, I must make sure they pay it. They pay them. That was how all my debts were paid. Dr. Udi. Dr. Bia, Idika, I have understood your case. There's no way the commission will send you, and there will not be backup financially. For this, we are going to pay you 6 months to $2,000. And when they paid 5 months, voila, Ajayi cancelled it. And fought against it till today. These are this, but Jimmy, I'm telling you by his grace, I won't allow what happened to me to happen. But if you decide to be like Moses, not to seek from where you were picked from, a man that has passed through the same thing and succeeded, and you now move in because you are a Benin, you only want Benin people, or people that look like Benin Yoruba people, you don't need an Igbo man that picked you from Malaysia, from no place, and brought you to the family, great family of Church of Commission. Today you are saying, Mama, you know he's a Igbo man. I'm a Benin man like you. So he cannot be above me. Igbo people will always be under me, under us. And that's what is happening in Church of Commission. But yet it doesn't move me because I'm not serving the administration, I'm serving the God of Archbishop. The God that laid the foundation of the corruption. The God that told me, go and raise the next generation. Indica, they will throw stone at you. They will disappoint you. They will betray you. But if you will not give up, if you will follow these 6 steps, he was working out the power that is attacking you. Your greatness will amaze them. Your success will baffle them, will bulldoze and caricature them. You know, these are good English. The only good is helping me to speak with English. So, take it wrong, sinner. So, number four, please don't play with your mind. beg you, Jimmy. No matter what you see, that is why you will be careful to marry. Don't marry other Sefina. Do you know there was one that wanted to deceive me? I didn't know how she was able to move in the dream. She said, you're going to have a dream that you are my wife, that I'm your husband, I'm your wife. Only God helped me to sleep. And I slept, I saw a dream where she was my wife. And I'm a man that doesn't take my dream for granted. Time off my mother, I went to my mother. My mother said, give me time. I've never seen this girl. I've never seen her in the dream. But I've seen your nurse. I've seen your wife. I've seen your wife in the dream. Who is this girl? My woman, I came back 2 days and said, Idika, this is not your wife. I was confused. I've already had a dream. Dream is the only way I see God. Now, when I saw my wife, I took a picture. I showed my wife. I showed my mom. Is this the woman you saw? Oh, look at the picture. My mother looked at it. He said, no. This is not the truth. I'm telling you, when you are doing spiritual, you make sure it's face to face sometimes. When I now say my mom that my wife is now in Nigeria, she's coming to see you. I want to bring her. She was far at the gate. My woman said, that's the woman I saw. That is the woman I saw. But when I showed the picture, technology, interference of technology, don't allow me to make everything spiritual. My wife said, that's my daughter-in-law. My mother says, come, Asana, from the different day she saw my mother, the mom started cleaning her leg, cleaning her, treating her like a person, no argument. Because my mom was too much prophetic. Please, make sure you go around all the confirmation. So that when challenge comes, you say, no, I know who I married. She's my wife. This is just a challenge. I want to be legit. I want to be legal. But anything I want to say, what is the fifth one? Anything that I can find, anything God asks you to do, read it now. I'm just moving ahead of time.
Whatsoever thy hand findeth to do, do it with thy might.
The fifth thing is, he called you, the other day I was directing you. Eli did not give Samuel money. He only directed him how to talk. He said, when you hear the voice again, he said, say again. What did Eli tell you? He said, speak low. That was the only thing. But Samuel, it was hard for Samuel to communicate, to connect with God without Eli. And I told you, anytime people ask you what is your vision, first of all, introduce yourself. As a pastor, you were telling me you're a scientist. What is your vision in life? I want to change the world. I want to read psychology. I want to read physiology. I want to read Santorogoto. You were saying nonsense. You made no point. Because I know you are a pastor first. As a pastor, even if you say, dear God, that's 50% what is your call. Because it's written in the Bible. What I want to achieve, you see the mindset in the youth now in Australia, it's not right. And that mindset is leading them to be living in the street. It's the same thing. It's the same thing you said, I want to change the world. But you first of all introduce who you are. He that off direct his conversation arrived. You see the salvation of the Lord, 50:23 of salvation. Whatever God has told you, be proud of it. Do it diligently. That's number five. Number six. Never you depend on your wisdom. Never you depend. The race is not for the swift, nor the battle for the strong. Yes, what is it?
For there is no work, no device, no knowledge, no wisdom in the grave, whither that goes.
He's still talking about that fifth one, yeah?
I return and so under the sun, that the race is not for the swift.
The race is never you should stand up. Never you depend on your wisdom. Never you depend. Two ways. Two things that make us sin, suffering, and being at the wrong place. He said, never you think because you are smart, never you think because you are wise, that you don't need God to succeed. You don't need God to succeed. Never you, this is another thing. What does that mean? Make the Bible your compass. Make the Bible your GPS. Make Holy Spirit your guide. Make God, Jehovah, the power behind the word of God. Does that make sense, church? Number one is what? Make sure God has accepted your work. Number two, when he accepted, live righteously. Number three, when you are living righteously, please don't break away. Don't break rank. It's not your business. Why are you breaking away? You're going to start your own. Is it still the same kingdom? Prove that it's the same kingdom. Number four, don't play with your marriage. Please, beg down the fire. Number six, anything God has asked you to do, do it with all diligence. Number six, please, make the Bible your compass. The race is not for the swift. You don't know anything. In your intelligence, in your PhD, it's, the Bible says it's like a rat, a dirty rat before God. You see, man's wisdom is foolishness before God. Never you depend on your certificate. Never you depend on your intelligence. Never you depend on anything. Depend on the only one thing, Jehovah and his word. May the Lord bless you. May the Lord cause his face to shine upon you. May the Lord give you peace beyond your understanding. Even as we share the grace of fellowship, may the grace of our Lord.